Hi, this is CATCAM Lessons channel and welcome to another part of the FreeCAD beginners tutorial where I show basic concepts related to creating 3D models in this system. FreeCAD is a completely free 3D CAD system where we can create our own 3D models, which we can for example use for 3D printing or collaborate with other CATCAM systems or with other people. You can find the link to the other parts of the tutorial in the description of this video. Now let's move on to a new project which we will create in the part design module, and you will learn more possibilities for creating 3D models in FreeCAD. We will start by creating a sketch. This time choose the XZ plane as the sketch plane. Along the way you will learn more about creating geometry in the sketcher, and a very basic geometry is a line, and when it comes to drawing lines we simply indicate two points of the line, that is we indicate the beginning and the end of the line. The line drawing command is still active and we can create more lines, and using auto constraints, if this option is enabled, we can link new line segment with previous geometry. If I hover the cursor over some geometry, for example this point, and click here, the beginning of new line will be linked to the end of this line. If I hover the cursor over a line and click the left mouse button, this point of the line is linked to this line. I can move this point only along this line, but I can move this point in such a way that it will be outside the line but still in line with this geometry. In this way we can create lines, but if you want to create geometry consisting of several lines, a better solution might be to use the polyline drawing command. Now if you choose this command, creating subsequent line segments, the beginning of the next segment is automatically linked to the end of the previous polyline segment, which can significantly facilitate creating shapes consisting of several segments. Now I will delete this geometry. Okay, and choose polyline drawing again and draw another shape and place the first point of the polyline at the origin of the coordinate system, then place the second point on the y-axis to get something like this and draw the next points roughly like this. Now place the next point on the x-axis so that a constraint appears here. Hover the cursor over the x-axis and when the axis is highlighted, click the left mouse button to link the point with the x-axis and draw the next segment of the polyline so that it ends at this point. Okay, we have drawn a polyline, it's a closed geometry. Right click to finish drawing the polyline and right click again to cancel the polyline drawing command. This geometry is not yet dimensioned, the sketch is not constrained, and here in my example I made a mistake or something doesn't work, so I need the constraint here. I select this point and this line and select constraint point onto object. Okay, and now let's add some dimensions. First let's select this dimension and select this line and here enter 100 millimeters. Okay, then select this line and here enter 20 millimeters. Okay, now we will dimension the vertical distances. Select this dimension, select this line and enter here 50 millimeters. Okay, and here enter 15 millimeters. Okay, and now let's an angle dimension. Select this dimension and select this line and this line, and here enter 150 degrees. Okay, the sketch is not fully constrained yet. We have 1 degree of freedom. Okay, we need one more dimension. Before we select the dimension, left click outside the geometry to deselect the selected geometries, and now select this dimension, select this line and enter here 10 millimeters. Okay, the geometry is fully constrained. Close the sketch, and now based on this sketch, to create a solid, we can for example add simple extrusion. This will create a solid by extruding the sketch, which we did in previous parts of the tutorial. Simply a solid will be created by extruding the sketch. Cancel this operation. And another way to create 3D solids in 3D CAD systems is to create a 3D solid by rotating the sketch around a selected axis. This is the revolution command. Select this operation, and here, as you can see, a solid has been created by rotating the sketch around the specified axis. By default, vertical sketch axis is chosen as the axis, and the solid is created this way. If we choose, for example, the horizontal sketch axis, the solid will be created this way. We can choose the horizontal or vertical axis of the sketch, or we can choose the base axis of the coordinate system, the base x-axis, the base y-axis, and the base z-axis, or we can choose select reference, and we can indicate some geometry in the work area. In this case, select either the horizontal sketch axis or the base x-axis, and we get the same effect, and the solid is created this way. Next, we have the angle parameter. Here, the angle is set to 360 degrees, so we perform a full rotation of the sketch around the selected axis. If you enter a different value here, for example 200 degrees, the solid will be created this way. Simply, the sketch is rotated by 200 degrees and such a fragment of the solid is created. Here I return to 360 degrees. Okay, click OK. And in this way, we created a solid by rotating the sketch. Of course, we can create another shape, more complex, but in this simple example, I wanted to show you how this operation works and how we can create a solid by rotating the sketch. Alongside sketch extrusion, this is another basic operation for creating 3D solids based on a 2D sketch. And when it comes to creating 3D solids, we can combine these operations. Here nothing stands in the way of creating another sketch. This time, let's create the sketch on the XY plane and create, for example, rectangle. Select centered rectangle and place the center of the rectangle at the origin of the coordinate system. Draw this shape, and here, as you can see, this solid obscures the geometry a bit, and to make the sketch fully visible, we can switch to the section view. Simply, the section view is the view of the sketch plane. Here we can add dimensions to this rectangle, and we can also use constraints. I will create a reference geometry to this edge. Okay. And now let's select this point and this line and select constraint point onto object. And select this dimension, select this line, and here enter 15 millimeters. Okay. And the sketch is fully constraint, close the sketch, and now based on this sketch add an extrusion and create another fragment of the 3D solid. And we created this solid by combining two basic 3D solid creation operations: sketch extrusion by rotation and simple sketch extrusion. And this simple example shows that we can combine 3D solid creation operations. Here, of course, you can add a material removal operation based on the sketch. We can create another sketch, for example, a sketch on this face. Select this face and create sketch and add another centered rectangle, more or less like this. Okay, close the sketch and add a pocket operation based on this sketch. And when creating 3D models, we often work this way, using different 3D solid creation operations when designing single part. We have the option, so if needed, we can use it. And just like with the simple extrusion, where we added a model based on a 2D sketch, and with the pocket operation, where we removed material based on a 2D sketch, we have a similar situation with creating a 3D solid by rotating a sketch. We have an inverse operation that removes material based on a 2D sketch by rotating the sketch. Now let's create another sketch on the XY plane. First, use Create External Geometry option and select this line. Okay. Now let's create circle here. Now let's switch to the section view, select this point and this point, and make them horizontally constrained. Okay, add the distance between this point and this point, enter here 10 millimeters. Okay, and dimension the circle diameter, and here also enter 10 millimeters. Okay, close the sketch. And now, based on this sketch, remove material by rotating the sketch. The operation that allows this is the groove operation. Select this operation. And here, by default, the vertical sketch axis is selected. Switch to the base X axis. And now, such a groove is created. We have the angle set to 360 degrees, so the cut by rotating the sketch is performed over the full angle. Here I can change the value and set it to, for example, 180 degrees. Okay, and we have a groove created this way. Click OK to confirm. And this was another basic operation that can be used in creating 3D solids. Often, when creating 3D models, we use different 3D solid creation operations. I mention this because I want you to know that when creating a single 3D solid, we can use different 3D solid creation operations. And that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and if you don't want to miss the next videos about FreeCAD, please subscribe to this channel.